The Redbreast brand was owned by Gilbey's of Ireland, but was bought by Irish distillers in the early 1970s. At the time, there were numerous other Bonder brands, so why buy this one? Well, it's not called a priest's tipple for nothing. In the Ireland of its day, this was the whisky of those in the know. You see, Redbreast was sold as a John Jameson pure make and has always had a special place in the hearts and in the drinks cabinets of Ireland.
Redbreast is a reflection of Irish whiskey as it used to be and always should be, in that it reflects the pot still style, which is the tradition of Irish whiskey going back over the years. So you might ask, what is the involvement of the master blender in a single pot still Irish whiskey if it's not blended? Well, in fact, there's an awful lot of blending goes into a single pot still Irish whiskey. And if you take Redbreast as an example, there's an age statement on the label, 12 years old. And that means that the youngest whiskey in that bottle is 12 years old. Doesn't mean that all the whiskey's 12 years old, because to get the mix right and the style, all the flavour characteristics right, we will use a range of ages, the youngest being 12, but you know, it can be a few years older in that, to get the whole thing together as I want it to be. I mean, it's often said that the distiller is the scientist and the blender is the artist. As blender, my artist palette would be the various distillates initially, the cask types that those distillates are filled into, and also the period of time that those casks are in warehouse. And only then can you even think about how you can put together different brands. And Redbreast 12-year-old, I mean, is a very good example to take, because we're looking at specific spirit types, specific cask types, and a specific age of whiskey.
Hold a glass of Redbreast up to the light, and at its heart you will see a rosy glow. The whiskey is called after the Robin Redbreast. Maybe this is what inspired the name. But the red glow gives us a glimpse into this unique style of whiskey, because the whiskies in Redbreast carry the unmistakable colour and tang that comes from whiskey matured in sherry butts. And not just any sherry butts. These are the finest in the world, built and filled to order. The sherry that filled these casks was specially selected in Jerez, Spain. The casks were left there to mature, and then emptied and brought back to Ireland to be filled with pot still whiskey.
The sherry butts in particular have a big impact on the flavour of Redbreast. It gives it the deep, dried, fruity notes, which is probably the signature of Redbreast.
The master blender is just one of the people to leave their imprint on Redbreast. The other is the cooper. Nothing has changed in the way sherry casks are repaired at the Middleton distillery. It's still all done by hand and eye. And as you'd expect with a craft as old as this, the skills are still passed down from generation to generation.
Every cask that you repair is different. When you would take a stave out of a cask, it can be different size, different width, different height. Some casks are very easy to repair, and some have a stubborn personality and just fight you every step of the way. I'm a fifth generation cooper, having served my time to my father originally, which is a great thrill to having learned all my craft and skill from my father directly, using the tools that he used throughout his working life, as his grandfather and his father had done, You can see the wear on the tools and the generations they've served and still serving. The whiskey, when it goes into a cask first, is quite clear and see-through, but is dependent on the cask to give it its final taste and colour. And it's that colour that the cask will really impart. And after possibly two and a half years, it starts to change. So it's that rounding off effect that you're looking for when you put your whiskey into a cask.
The whiskey that goes on to become Redbreast will mature in these casks for at least 12 years, and possibly longer.
I like to think that when casks are put into warehouse, that magic starts in a cask, in that that interaction with the air, the wood, the whiskey, the environment, can't be copied or manufactured. It has to be just left to rest. And traditionally, coopers would have been in warehouse bedding down casks for their long sleep.
Taking Redbreast, for example, all the sherry contribution that there is. And I can go in there and take a sip, hold it in my mouth for minutes, and just dissect it and pick up all the little fruity notes, and where there's something that I didn't notice before. Where is that coming from? Is that coming from the sherry, or is that coming from the bourbon? Where is it coming from? Is it a distillate characteristic that I haven't picked up before? And sometimes, whenever you leave your glass of Redbreast sitting there for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you can go back to it and say, well, something's changed there. Why is that changing? How is it changing? Is this something that I should be picking up on, you know? It's fascinating. And, I mean, I've been in the business 34 years and it still excites me, you know, things like this.
Redbreast is regarded as the definitive, the closest to the traditional full-bodied whiskey. No wonder it's had a loyal core of followers for so long.